Please welcome Dice Raw.
I'm a musician, so, you know, I like to get high, and I think that most musicians get high. I mean, some musicians don't get high or take a sip or whatever, and their shit sucks, you know what I'm saying? And I mean, Jimi Hendrix got high, Kurt Cobain got high, James Brown got high. It's like, yo, I actually wonder who got the highest, you know what I'm saying? Like, who's the motherfucking artist that's like, people like, yo, you don't want to smoke that, smoke with that motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, he's got something special in that joint. But maybe it was Jimmy because, you know, he died, you know what I mean, while getting high. I mean, like, I guess that's the ultimate, you know, the OD. You know what I'm saying? It's not funny, but I mean, you know, it's kind of funny. But all those 60s and 70s guys, I mean, they got really fucking smashed. Like, even Sammy Davis Jr. was getting fucked up. You know, the Doors, the Beatles. And I mean, this is a part of a real American history. But, you know, I mean, I think that Dylan in that time, though, in the 60s and 70s, is like, how don't you get high? You know what I'm saying? The Vietnam War, the Civil Rights Movement, the Women's Movement, you know, oppression, and, you know, Jim Crow, and, you know, Martin Luther King getting shot, J.F. Kennedy getting shot, Malcolm X getting shot, John F. Kennedy. It's like, they were just fucking killing every fucking body. You know what I'm saying? It's like, how don't you get high? Like, who's the motherfuckers back then? It's like, nah, I'll pass. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, pass. It's like... But, yo, the one group that I'm sure that probably didn't get high was the Monkees. The Monkees, yeah. You know, I mean, and I got to do some research on it, but it would make sense because if the Monkees didn't get high, because their music was fucking corny as shit. I mean, the fucking... I'm sorry. You know, if you're a Monkees fan out there and you're offended, I'm sorry. The Monkees fucking were the worst group ever. You know what I'm saying? And for obvious reasons, I hate the name. The Monkees? It's like, yeah, whatever. It's like, I think some racist motherfucker came up with that name and got talked out of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, at first it was like a black group, and he was like, yo, I want to call a black group, you know, on Motown, we want to call them the Monkees. And it's like, yo, I don't think so, man. That group sounds like it's going to fucking suck. You know what I'm saying? But when you really think about it, though, I mean, there are no black bands with animal names. Think about that shit. There's no fucking black bands with animal names. And I mean, white guys, they took all the names that I guess make sense for groups already. It's like, thanks, white guys. You're at it again. You know what I'm saying? You got the Birds was a good group. I like some of the songs from the Birds, you know, the Beatles. You know, you had the fucking, I mean, you know, the Monkees again. And what else? What else is I can't think of any other. The Turtles. You had the Turtles, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, the shit is so fucked up, though, like with the stigma of African-American males being like the face of criminality, and, you know, we're gangsters and we're tough and we're bad and we're someone that you should be afraid of, when that's not the case at all. I mean, but in music, I guess it is the case because it's so gangster. Like, if it was a black group, I mean, what would they call themselves? I mean, it would have to be like some fucking... the Lions or like the Sharks, you know what I'm saying? It's like you start running out of fucking animal names that the fucking fuck with. It's like they're dangerous. Maybe the Alligators, you know? What about the Cobras? Nah, not the Cobras. It's like, damn, we're running out of fucking animal names. It's like, you know, the crazy part about that, though, is that before we picked an animal name, we decided to call ourselves the Niggas. I mean, think about that shit. There's a group of African-American males that was quadruple platinum, multi-platinum, selling out the fucking ass, every fucking show, arena packed. And they were called the Niggas with Attitudes. Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, Eazy-E, MC Ren, and Yella Boy. The Niggas with Attitudes. I mean, that's some shit. And you know what? I guess when you think about it, maybe they even came up with the whole idea of calling themselves Niggas with Attitudes is because they ran out of animal names to come up with. That was all they could think of. Maybe they were trying to come up with a good animal name, and they didn't. because there weren't any. Because African-American males can't get the right animal names for a music group. And that's a problem with oppression. Before we can think of a good animal name, like the lions, the sharks, the alligators, no. The niggas. It's like, yo, and the shit worked. The shit fucking worked. It's like, so what does that say about you? You know what I'm saying? America. You know what I'm saying? I mean, me too. I mean, look, I ain't gonna front. When NWA dropped that shit, I was sneaking listening to that shit because I was little and I was bumping that shit and I fucking loved every word. Fuck the police. You goddamn right. I'm a fucking 6-year-old singing fuck the police. I mean, like, yo, this is something new. I mean, as a kid, when you're growing up, I mean, most kids in the suburbs, I mean, these motherfuckers, you want to be a police officer when you grow up. I mean, and at 6 years old, your mind is set on fuck the police. And I mean, not I want to be a cop when I grow up or a fireman. It's like, fuck them. I mean, like, that's some shit.